Now, whenever a question based on integration of rational function comes and you observe that your denominator function is factorizable. Okay, so if you observe that your denominator function q of x or q of x polynomial is factorizable and the degree of the polynomial in the numerator is lesser than the degree of the polynomial in the denominator, that means degree of p of x is lesser than the degree of q of x, then under these circumstances you can actually integrate that rational function. So under this situation you can actually apply partial fraction. Now please note that the second condition is not mandatory, but of course the first one is, because if the denominator is not factorizable, partial fraction will be of no use. Why I am saying the second condition is optional is because even if the degree of the numerator polynomial is higher than the degree of the denominator polynomial, you can still divide it. Correct? Divide it and convert it in such a form that the quotient plus remainder by divisor, that remainder by divisor thing can be converted to partial fractions. Okay. Let me just give an example. I know you would be aware of this. Let's say if I want to integrate dx by x plus 1 whole square times, let's say, x plus 3. Okay. Now, because your denominator is factorizable, numerator of course is a constant of degree lesser than the denominator. First of all, forget about the integration. Let's focus on converting this into partial fraction. Hope you all are aware of converting it into partial fraction. What do we write? A by x plus 1, B by x plus 1 whole square, plus C by x plus 3. All of you are aware of partial fractions. If let's say one of the factors is a quadratic factor, then what would you write? AX plus B by the quadratic. Let's say if this is a quadratic factor which is repeated, let's say x square plus 1 whole square, then what will you write?
A by x plus 1 plus B by x plus 1 whole square.
Okay, let me just give you a question. How do I write the partial fraction representation for this? Just tell me the representation. A by x plus 1, B by x plus 1 square, plus cx by d by x square plus 1, plus ex plus f by x square plus 1.
So,
1
by x
square
plus 1, then you can't
do it.
If the question is 1 by x square plus 1, then you can't apply 1 by x.
What's the point?
No,
okay, I'm giving you a very simple one. I'm saying
if you 1 by x square plus 1, you will write it as a by x square plus 1 only.
It's
a is
1. It's tan inverse x.
No, he's just giving some.
As an example, like, I don't need
it. Will not. Yeah, if the denominator is not factorizable, partial fraction is useless. Yeah, now you know how to get the value of A, B, C, let's say for this question. There are two ways again. One is by use of special substitution. Other is by comparing the coefficient of various powers of x. Yeah. I'll recommend use special substitutions as far as you can. Okay. You can use a mix of both the approaches. But start with special substitution first, because it will give you some of the values of A, B, C really, really, really fast. For example, in this case, if I have to find the value of A, B, C, let me first take the LCM over here, which is x plus 1 whole square times x plus 3. So it is A x plus 1, x plus 3, B x plus 3, C x plus 1 whole square. Okay, now remove the denominator, so 1 is equal to this. Now to find the value of ABC, we can use special substitutions. Can you recommend some substitutions?
Minus 1.
Minus 1, right? If you see x plus 1, the best substitution is put x as minus 1 first. So when you put minus 1, left side will remain 1, 0, 0, 2b. So b is what? Half. Straight away we got b. Then minus 3. Minus 3 will make this 0, this has 0. This will become 4c. So 1 is 4c. So c is equal to 1 by 4. Now you can put other substitution also if you want. For example, I can put x as 0 also. Okay, please note. Substituting x as 0 is like comparing the constant terms on both the sides. Please remember that. I have seen people doing this mistake. They compare the constant term also, they put x as 0 also. You are going to get the same thing back again. So just remember, save your time, don't do this mistake. Substituting x is 0 is equivalent to comparing constant terms on both the sides. Okay. So when you substitute x as 0 or you compare the constant term on both the sides, so 1 will be equal to 3a plus 3b plus c. 3a means 3 by 2. 3b means?
So
3 is 3 by 2. 3b is 3 by 2. C is 1 by 4. This is equivalent to saying 6 by 4, which is 7 by 4. So 3a is equal to minus 3 by 4. So a is minus 1 by 4. Okay. So once you get the value of the constants over here, it really becomes very, very easy to integrate it, because integration of this and this is simple. What is the answer for this? Minus 1 by 4 ln of mod x plus 1. What is the answer for this? Minus half 1 by x plus 1. This again 1 fourth ln mod x plus 3. Is this okay? So let's take a few problems on integration of rational functions using partial fractions.
Don't start applying partial fraction at this form, because this is not a rational function. Partial fraction is applied only to rational functions, but you can also apply it to transcendental functions only after substitution. For example, even if there is a trigonometric function, you can apply a partial fraction, but only after you have substituted a trigonometric function into rational functions. For example, take sin x as t, then you will get a rational function from there.
Directly
you don't apply partial fraction there. It doesn't work.
Why exactly?
Doesn't
work. Here hint is, take t as x e to the power cos x. After that you should be able to. Okay, so using this substitution I can write the numerator as dt by e to the power cos x
into 1 minus t.
Okay. And this is an x over here.
Yeah.
Now x into e to the power cos x will combine again to give you
e.
Now it is in the form of
t.
From here you can now split it up as t 1 minus t 1 plus t plus t squared. Now break it up as partial fraction a by t, b by 1 minus t, then c t plus d by t square plus t plus 1. Okay.
Yeah.
Now let's say, assuming in the interest of time, assuming you know the value of a, b, c, d now, how do we do the last one? This is easy, right? A ln t. This is minus b ln 1 minus t. Not exactly. You have to express the numerator as a times derivative of the denominator plus b. Do you remember the approach?
Yes.
Px plus
plus q by ax square plus bx plus c. And then from there you can do it. Yeah, of course one of them will come as completing the square. Other one will come as directly ln of the dt by d, ln of the denominator. So please complete this problem. So I am going to stop here. Next class I am going to talk about integration of irrational algebraic functions. And give you an idea about reduction formula.
So what formula?
Reduction formula. And just for 45 minutes or so. And then we are going to begin with definite integrals. So definitely we are going to start with definite integrals.